Christmas is a big deal for my family. And every year, I'm this problem they all have to solve. Because I'm always the single one.
I think you should come home with me. We can pretend we fell in love after all these years.
It'd be so easy. My family already asked why we're not just together.
All right.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, Slay Queen Carol?
You have to call her Christmas Carol.
How did I not know your mom had a holiday-specific drag name?
You get a pair, and you get a pair. Who am I?
Oprah.
Oh, right. Yeah. Oh, of course you guys do that. Your family really wants you to have a relationship.
Yes, I know. That's very clear.
So my early Christmas present for you is a blind date.
I love it.
He loves it.
You're going.
You're going.
Where are you
going? He's going on a blind date.
Like from Grindr?
Oh, my God.
We talk on pillows and snowy white
sheets. I was thinking we could grab a cup of coffee.
You probably thought you were going on a date with the hottest, smartest, funniest, coolest, most interesting person who was ever born.
Maybe I am.
My date with James went well.
Oh, I'm so happy. That is so great.
I always thought that you and Peter should be together.
Well, I'm his best friend.
Well, my wife is my best friend in the whole world.
Get dressed and get cute.
Such a pusher.
Don that gay apparel.
Shut up.
People who look at each other like that are not just friends.
Nick and Peter want to make out. They should make out.
Oh, that's good.
Nick is a 10, and Peter's a 10 in New Hampshire.
These stars came with the trees. I love them.
I do, too.
The girls are in my bed.
Of course they are.
You have feelings for him.
If Nick and I ever went there and didn't work out, I would lose him.
But what if it did work out?
The gays just know how to do stuff. For some reason, you're always obsessed with me.